Let's move and let's talk about refiners now. State-run refiner IOC will invest 1,80,000 crores in the next 5 to 6 years. That's the word coming in from Chairman B. Ashok. Priyanka, I here spoke with him and started by asking him about the outlook for gross refining margins going forward. Listening to what he had to say.
See, our quarter one GRM was $9.98 per barrel. If you leave out the inventory effect, the GRM would have been around $4.5 a barrel. So certainly the inventories have contributed to our significant increase in terms of GRM. But you must factor that we have been losing heavily on inventories over the last couple of years. Our inventory losses were very high, both in 14-15 as well as in 15-16. So moving forward, I don't believe that we should be having that sort of an inventory effect over the whole year during the financial year, because it is widely expected that the crude oil prices will be more range-bound. So there could be some fluctuations, but it will be more of normalization over time. So I don't think that there should be much of an inventory effect moving forward. So that being the case, if we are able to sustain our operations the way we have been able to in the last couple of years in terms of operational excellence of our refineries, we should be able to make decent profits, decent GRMs in the refineries. The other thing which will add positively to our GRM would be the Paradip Refinery, which is currently on the stabilization mode. As you know, this was dedicated to the nation on 7th of February in the current year. It is a very complex refinery with multiple units, and the units have been in various stages of stabilization. Now all the units in this refinery have been commissioned, and probably within the next 1 month or so, we should be in a position to operate all of these units together on a sustained basis. So once we do that, we believe that Paradip Refinery's contribution alone should be at least $2 to $3 more per barrel, and that will certainly pick up our average in terms of overall refining margins.
So is there any volume guidance that you can give for FY17?
See, the growths have been quite robust, especially in gasoline. There's been a double-digit growth. And even in diesel, I would say that while the last month or so has been a little muted, probably due to rain effect and others, during the first quarter, the diesel growth was also quite good. And moving forward, we think that overall there should be anything between 6% and 8% growth should be possible.
So what is your capex for FY17, and going ahead, what are your investment plans in the coming few years?
During the current year, we should be investing close to 15,000 crores on the various projects which are in various stages of implementation. In the next 3 years, we are expecting an investment of close to 72,000 crores. So there will be a significant step up in terms of our capex for the next 3 years from FY18 onwards. And we have also made an assessment that in the next 6 to 7 years, we need to invest close to 1,80,000 crores. This would include significant capacity additions and quality upgradations in our refineries. Almost 24 million tons of additional capacity additions would be there in through brownfield expansions. Besides that, a lot of pipeline projects which are getting built up, almost close to 6,500 kilometers of pipelines would be built up. And there will be marketing infrastructure which will be set up. Petrochemicals, there are a number of projects which are in various stages of implementation. So that would also call for significant investments. On natural gas, we are making, huge investments, including the first regasification terminal in the East Coast, our Ennur terminal, where the project implementation is going on at the moment. And more projects are also being considered. And pipelines are being added for natural gas as well. So all this calls for significant investment in the natural gas business. Above all this, we are also looking at E&P. Seeing the current trend in the world market where low prices, it's a window for us. So we are looking at quite aggressively in terms of getting some equity oil or getting some assets overseas. So some good opportunities had come up recently in Russia. So as a consortium, we have gone to Russia, and we have been able to sort of firm up on two major assets. One is both of which are producing assets. So these will be very good additions to our portfolio.
So what are your marketing margins at currently, and what is your outlook for the coming year?
See, marketing margins, I would not say that they are very significantly different. But what is of significance is that since the industry is decontrolled, we do not have any under recoveries, which we used to have earlier. So there is clearly no under recoveries in marketing of the automotive fuels. So that's a plus. The second thing is on LPG, I mean, we are today selling it at market determined prices. And even on PDS kerosene, we are able to get the reimbursement from the government. So in terms of an under recovery, we are not suffering any sort of an under recovery on any of your fuel products. But in retail business, what has really helped us is that due to freeing of prices, we are able to do certain amount of market determined pricing at the point, and probably 15 to 20% of our volumes are based on certain market determined pricing mechanisms which we are implementing. Besides that, there is a lot of emphasis on non-fuel retailing activities, both on our regular outlets, our highway outlets, as well as on our rural outlets. So these non-fuel items are also adding to our margins. So all put together, I think that is where the marketing margins are going.